Hi, my name is Kevin and I'm a support engineer at PreEmptive. Today I want to show you a demo of Dotfuscator, our .NET protection product. I'm going to start off by showing you how easy it is for anyone to reverse engineer a .NET application. Then I'll show you just how easy it is to protect that application from an attack using Dotfuscator. I'm going to demonstrate Dotfuscator today with a sample application called PingUtil. It's a really simple application that sends pings and records the results. Obfuscation takes place on compiled assemblies, so I'm going to show Dotfuscator protecting an actual working application. I'm just going to configure this to start sending pings so you can see that it's a working application. We'll set it up to ping PreEmptive's website. Okay, so you can see that it's sending pings and recording the responses. Okay, now let's see how easy it is to decompile this application and look at the source code. I'm going to use a common reverse engineering tool called ILSpy. It's an open source decompiler available on GitHub. It's that simple to get a tool to reverse engineer a .NET application. All I need to do is select the assemblies I want to reverse engineer, and they'll appear here in the tree. I select what I want to look at, and the code shows up here in the viewer. I can easily view the various form components, as well as the code behind the generate graph and save responses. I can even look at the supporting DLL to see the methods used to make a ping. So now I'll show you how easy it is to protect this application using Dotfuscator. I'll create a new project so we could obfuscate the PingUtil. I'm going to navigate to where the PingUtil assemblies are stored and add them to Dotfuscator. Okay, so here are the assemblies loaded into the configuration tool. You'll notice that I did not include the NSSpring or ZGraph DLLs. The reason I left those out is that they're third-party DLLs, and I want to show that the references to these DLLs will still work even if they're not run through Dotfuscator. The point here is that you don't have to obfuscate them. You can combine the obfuscated and non-obfuscated assemblies. Next, let's review some high-level settings. As you can see, there's quite a few that we can apply to our project. To keep it simple, I'm just going to focus on a few settings. The first thing I want to show you is that you can turn on or off each one of the obfuscation features globally. You can see here that the defaults are to have control flow and renaming turned on and everything else turned off. As you can see, each obfuscation transform has a corresponding tab. So let's look at renaming. Renaming is a process that obfuscates code by replacing the descriptive names of methods and fields with names like A or F that don't give any clue as to their purpose. It's completely impossible for someone to reverse engineer this transform, so the best a hacker can do is try to read each line of code to figure out what the method does. In addition to making decompiled output much more difficult to understand, it also makes the resulting executable smaller in size. One result of this is that renaming often improves application performance. Dotfuscator provides you the options to exclude specific areas of code from renaming. You can see here that you can choose to exclude an entire assembly, or you can drill down to whatever level works for your needs. You can also define custom rules using regular expressions to identify namespaces, types, methods, or fields to exclude. There are quite a few more detailed options for renaming, but I won't get into those now. Now let's run our project. It will ask if we'd like to save our configuration before we run our obfuscation build. This creates an XML file which contains all of the settings we've applied to this project. You can see it working here in the build output console. This is where any errors you may experience will be displayed. Let's see what reverse engineering looks like after obfuscation. I'll try to open the obfuscated assemblies created by Dotfuscator. Now when I try to look at the code, you can see that the code that showed up here last time has been obfuscated and is no longer available for me to read. Now let's make sure the obfuscated application still runs normally. We'll set it up to ping our website again. You can see here that the graphing still works too. If you remember, I did not obfuscate the ZGraph DLL because I wanted to show you that you did not have to obfuscate third-party DLLs. When we created and saved our Dotfuscator project, it created an XML file. This allows you to run the same project using a command line prompt and use it in an automated build scenario. So that was a very quick overview of our Dotfuscator product. Remember, we offer free evaluations for you to test Dotfuscator on your own project. We're able to extend evaluations if you need more time and offer you support during the evaluation period if you have technical questions. If you'd like further information, please email us at solutions@preemptive.com.